Good morning students, let's learn today practice 8.1 question number 5. A cricket team played 121 games and won 66 games. Okay, how many games cricket team played? 121 games and won 66 games. Okay, what is the ratio? What is the ratio of games won to the number of games played? So what we have to find? We have to find the ratio of number of, what it is asked in the question, to find the ratio of games won to the number of games played. Okay, so required ratio what it is asked? Ratio of games won. Okay, ratio of games won to the number of games played. Okay, games won is to the number of games played. Okay, number of games played. Okay, what it is asked? We have to find the ratio of games won to the number of games played. Okay, now how many games won cricket team played? 121 games and won. How many games won? 66 games. Okay. And number of games played? 121 games played. Okay. So we have to find the ratio of these. Games won is to number of games played. Okay. So now let's see. Both the numbers are divisible by 11. Okay. See, 11 6s are 66, 11 11s are 121. Okay, see, 11 6s are 66, 11 1s are 11, 11 1s are 11. So, what we got answer? 6 upon 11. So, what is the ratio? 6 is to 11. Okay, 6 is to 11. And what after that, what it is asked? For every 11 games played, how many games were won? See, required ratio what we got? 6 is to 11. Required ratio what we got? 6 is to 11. After that, what it is asked? For every 11 games played, how many games were won? See, for every 11 games played, see, these are the number of games played. How many games were won and games won? These. So, what it is asked? For every 11 games played, 11 games played, how many games were won? How many games won? 6 games. Okay, so for second one, what you will write? Answer. For every 11 games played, how many games won? 6 games won. Okay, so 6 games won. See, 11 games played and every 11 games played, how many games won? How many games won? See, 11 games played. We got here ratio 6 is to 11. So, 11 is game played. So, how many games won? 6. 6 is to 11 is the ratio. Okay, so every 11 games played, how many games won? 6 games won. So, write here 6 games won. For question number 6, a student did 6 of 10 problems correctly. Okay, students did 6 of 10 problems correctly. So, total problems 10. Okay, total problems 10. Total problems 10. Okay, and what it is given? A student did 6 of 10 problems correctly. How many problems student did correctly? 6 problems. Means correct. Right answers, right problems, 6. Okay, a student did 6 of 10 problems correctly. Okay, so correct problem, correct problems, how much are there? 6 problems are correct. So now wrong problems how much? Okay, so the wrong problems how much? Correct problems 6 means correct answer 6. Total questions are 10. Total problems 10. From that 6 problems correct, then wrong problems 4. From 10 if you will subtract 6, then you will get the number of wrong problems. Okay, so problems. So how to find the wrong problems? Wrong problems. So how to find the wrong problems? What we'll do from total problems? We'll subtract the correct problems. Okay, six total problems are 10, and from that 6 problems are correct. So how many are wrong problems? 4. Okay, so wrong problems are 4. Okay, now what it is asked in the question? What is the ratio of the number of right problem to the number of wrong problems? Okay, so required ratio. What is the required ratio? Required ratio is the number of right problem, number of right problems is to number of wrong problems. Okay. What it is asked? What is the ratio of the number of right problems to the number of wrong problems? Okay. Now number of right problems, how much? 6. How many number of right problems? 6. And number of wrong problems? 4. So let's find the ratio of these. Both the numbers are, see, this is 6 and this is 4. Both the numbers are divisible by 2. So 2 2's are 4, 2 3's are 6. So 3 upon 2. So what is the ratio? 3 is to 2. Required ratio is 3 is to 2. And after that, what it is asked? For every 2 wrong answers, see, wrong problems, 2. See what ratio we got? We got the ratio number of right problems is to number of wrong problems, 3 is to 2. Means every 2 wrong answers, how many were right? These are the wrong problems and these are the correct problems, means right problems. So what it is asked? For every 2 wrong answers, see, these are the number of wrong problems. So every 2 wrong answers, how many were right? For every two wrong answers, 3 were right. So what we will write for this answer? For every 2 wrong answer, for every 2 wrong answers, how many were right? For every 2 wrong answers, 3 were right. Okay. 3 were right. So write here, 3 were right. Okay. So for every 2 wrong answers, 3 were right. Let's solve question number 7. The perimeter of a rectangular plot is 400 feet. What is given? Perimeter. Okay. Perimeter of rectangular plot. Perimeter. How much it is given? 400. Okay. 400 feet. After that, if the breadth of rectangular plot, means breadth of the plot is 50 feet. What it is given? Breadth. Breadth, how much it is given? 50. Feet. Okay, and find the ratio of length of rectangular plot to its width, which means breadth, in simplest form. Okay, so perimeter of rectangular plot it is given, breadth it is given, and it is asked to find the ratio length is to breadth. Length means breadth, length is to breadth. So we should know the length. Okay, then only we can find the ratio length is to width. Okay, here perimeter is given, breadth is given, and it is asked to find the ratio of length is to width. Okay, what it is asked? Find the ratio length is to width. But we don't know the length. So, first what we have to find? Let's find length. Okay, let's find length. So, now what we know is, we know perimeter, perimeter of rectangle. What is the formula for perimeter of rectangles here? Perimeter of rectangle, it is rectangular plot, so we have to write here perimeter of rectangle. What is the formula? 2 into bracket length plus breadth. So, 2 into bracket length plus bread. This is the formula for perimeter of rectangle. Okay. So now perimeter, how much it is given? 400 feet. How much perimeter it is given? 400. Okay. Then what it is given? Breadth is given. So write formula as it is. See, perimeter of rectangular plot it is given. So write here down of that 400. Okay. Perimeter of rectangular, here you can write rectangular plot also. Perimeter of rectangular plot is 400 feet. Now write this formula 2 into bracket. What we have to find? We have to find the length. Length right as it is. And breadth is given. How much it is? 50 feet plus. So in the place of breadth right here 50. Okay. So now 400. See, 2 is here multiplied. If you will transfer to this side, then it will become divide. See, 2 is multiplied for this bracket. If you will transfer to this side, then it will become divide. So transfer here. So what will remain here now? Length plus breadth means L plus 50. Okay. So now divide this. 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4, 2 zeros are 0, 2 zeros are 0. So 200 feet will remain here. Okay, 200 feet will remain here. Is equal to length plus 50 feet. Okay, now 50. 50 is here plus. If we will transfer to this side, then it will become minus. So 200 minus 50 feet is equal to what will remain? Length. Okay, so 200 minus 50, 150. So what we got? Length we got 150 feet. It is given in feet. So what we got length? Length we got 150 feet. See, here I am writing feet. Okay. So length we got 150 feet. Now what it is asked? Find the ratio of the length of rectangular plot to its width. Width means breadth. Okay. So required ratio. What we will write here? Required ratio. What is the ratio? Length is to width. What it is given? Find the ratio of the length of rectangular plot. Means length is to its width. So required ratio is length is to width. So what is the length? Length we got 150 feet. Okay, 150 feet. And what is the width? Width means breadth. What it is? 50. Okay. So now find the ratio of this. See now. Do the lowest term, upper 0, downside 0 get cancelled. Now what will remain? 15 upon 5. 5 ones are 5, 5 threes are 15. So 3 upon 1. 3 upon 1 means what is the ratio? 3 is to 1. So what it is asked? Find the ratio of the length of rectangular plot to its width in simplest form, and we find it in the simplest form. Okay, so what is the ratio? Required ratio is 3 is to 1. Question number 8. Mason K could complete only 3 integer 1 upon 4 of 6 words in a day, whereas Mason B completed 1 integer 1 upon 2 of 4 words in a day. Which Mason is more efficient than the other? Okay. So now see here, we'll solve this. We'll make two parts of this. Mason A. Here I will write for Mason A. Mason A. And here Mason B. Mason B. Okay. Now Mason A could complete only 3 integer 1 upon 4 of 6 walls in a day. Okay, Mason B completed, Mason B is here, okay, Mason B completed 1 integer 1 upon 2 of 4 words. Okay, 4 words in a day. Okay, so now let's solve this. 3 integer 1 upon 4, this is mixed fraction. So let's convert this in the improper fraction. 4 3s are 12, 12 and 1, 13, 13 upon 4. Of means multiplication, 6, multiple by 6, walls in a day. So now let's solve first for A. Okay, let's solve first for Mason A. 3 integer 1 upon 4 of 6 walls. So 3 integer 1 upon 4 we convert. are 4, 2 3s are 6. So what we got here, 13, this is multiplied by 3 and denominator is 2. Okay, 13 3s are 39 upon 2. Okay, what we got here, 39 upon 2. So Mason A, what we got, 39 upon 2. Now let's solve for Mason B. One integer 1 upon 2 of 4 walls in a day. So one integer 1 upon 2 means this is given fraction is mixed fraction. So let's convert in the improper fraction. 2 1s are 2 and 1 3. 3 upon 2. See, 2 1s are 2. 2 plus 1 3. 3 upon 2. Of means multiplication 4. Multiple by 4. See, of means multiplication 4. 4 walls in a day. So multiplied by 4. Okay. So now let's solve these also. 2 1s are 2. 2 2s are 4. 3 multiplied by 2. And here denominator is 1. So what we got? 3 2s are 6. 6 upon 1 means only 6. Now see, what it is asked, which Mason is more efficient than the other? Now for Mason A, what we got? 39 upon 2. And for Mason B, what we got? 6 upon 1 means 6 is 2. 1 we got. And it is asked which Mason is more efficient than the other. So we need to compare this. Which is more efficient? We need to compare this ratio. So for compare this ratio, you have learned already comparison of fraction. Same way we have to compare these also. Okay. So let's compare this. See. Let's compare these both. Okay. So Mason A, 39 upon 2, and Mason B, 6 upon 1, which is more efficient, that we have to compare. So for comparison, I will draw a box. Now denominator should be the same, then we can compare its numerator. But here denominators are different, so what we have to do, we have to make it same. For that, what we need to do, we need to find the LCM. Now here what is the denominator? 2. So let's make the denominator here also 2. So to make the denominator here 2, we need to multiply by 2 for the denominator. Okay, so right here 39 upon 2 as it is. So what will come here? 6 upon 1, 1 multiplied by 2. So we are multiplying by 2 for denominator. Same way we have to multiply by 2 for the numerator also. So what we got here? 39 upon 2, here we have 39 upon 2, and here we got 6 2s are 12 and 1 2s are 2. Okay, now we got denominator same. So what we have to do? We have to compare its numerator. Which is greater? This is greater. This is greater. This is greater means who is more efficient? Which Mason is more efficient? Mason A. 39 upon 2 we got for A. So Mason A is more efficient. Okay, so what you will write here, Mason A is more efficient.